Hello, my beautiful people out there. This is Kristen, and today I'm doing my book reviews of books that I read in January of 2019. I did not actually do a whole lot of reading in January. I just was not in a very bookish kind of mood. Just the dark winter would seem like an ideal time to curl up with a book, but I actually spent a lot of time playing some of those hidden puzzle app things. You know, it reminded me of my childhood. Would you remember those magazines highlights where there was like one page where you could find the hidden objects, and that was like obsessive? You always went to it first. I know that only people my age or older know what I'm talking about, but give me a thumbs up or a comment if you remember that. Anyway, that's where a lot of my reading time went, but I read four books. Well, I lied. I'll start with the fact that I actually haven't even finished my fourth book, but in my defense, it's The Count of Monte Cristo by Andrew Dumas, and it is 1,260 some pages. So I'm about 878. I'm on page 878. And I did read, I think, an abridged version of this earlier in my life, because I do not think I would have read a 1,200 page book when I was in college. I remember the story very well, though. I might have just seen the movie. So it's a story of a young man who is wrongfully accused of treason and imprisoned, and he has this awesome relationship that he develops with a fellow prisoner and this amazing escape, and then the person lets him know where some treasure is, which he pursues, and he uses that to reward those who have helped him in the past and to basically take revenge. So it's kind of a book full of revenge and very intricate plots. And so I'm about, two-thirds, three-quarters, something like that through, and it is great. I find myself, when he goes into side stories about the character that has just entered, that I'm really interested in that sideline, and I kind of forget the main story, which is a sign of a really good book. So I recommend it, and that will be my classic for February too, because I've still got about 400 pages left. So that will, I try to read one classic at least a month, so I think that can count for 2 months. I also read Honora Roberts. This one is Jewels of the Sun. It's a trilogy in Ireland, and Ireland is one of the top two bucket list places that I really, really want to go, New Zealand being the other. And Nora Roberts, I'm not a huge romance reader, but I like Nora Roberts. She has cute, sweet, just very kind of predictable romantic stories, but a lot of hers have to do with ghosts. This one has to do with fairies, kind of not leprechauns, but kind of fairy world in Ireland. And it's just a sweet romance story. There's, you know, good relationship building and interesting story plots. There's sex, but it's not over the top. It's just a nice, it's my kind of romance recommendation. Now, my nonfiction book that I read was Total Cat Mojo. This is Jackson Galaxy, who did the My Cats from Hell TV, I think that was in TLC, show, where he just really, really loves cats and has explored their history, their past behavior. The first kind of half of the book is all about that. It's got cute little illustrations and little sidebars, and makes it enjoyable to read and kind of just find out some of that information. And then the second to third back of the book is all about addressing specific cat issues. If your cat is having issues with fighting or not using its litter box correctly, or all those kind of things. And I have two cats and I love cats, and this was interesting. So I think that if you like cats and you're interested in cats, it's a really good read. And then the other book I read this month is Barbara Kingsolver's The Bean Trees. And this was a really easy, kind of shorter read. I think it was about 245 pages. And this was a story about a lower income, younger woman who's going across the country in a car that barely runs. And when she's crossing a Native American reservation, she is bestowed a young child that the family just wants this child to have a better life, and so she's on this adventure, and just all the interesting characters and small towns that she goes through, and some of the issues of racial tensions and those that she's encountered, a couple that has come up from some disruption in Guatemala and these kind of issues, Venezuela, all these things that remind me of some of the things that are going on now, right? So it was just an interesting, really well written. I really, really enjoy Barbara Kingsolver. I was a little disappointed actually in the Poisonwood Bible just because I had heard so much hype about it. But if I'm not expecting a lot of hype, I'm really highly entertained and very happy with her books. So there you have it, my four books that I participated in January. I will finish reading The Mount of The Count of Monte Cristo. I'm going to read Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. I have never read any of these series, but I'm really interested in them, so that's gonna be a goal for February. I'm probably gonna read the second Nora Roberts because it's a trilogy and I kind of wanna know the other two girls' stories. And then my nonfiction, I'm really interested in reading The Library Book by Susan Orlean. That is a story, or it's historical nonfiction about a library fire and about the books and the learnings from that experience. So I'm really excited about all those. We'll see, maybe I'll pick up a couple extras, but let me know what you're reading, if you've read any of the ones that I want to read. So leave me a comment, let me know what you're up to, and if you have any comments on any of these. Thank you so much. Y'all have a blessed day.